And welcome. It is 6 a.m. India time, or 30 minutes past midnight GMT, and it's 8:30 in the morning in Beijing. Hello and welcome. It's an event that takes place every 5 years, an event that chalks out the political, economic and foreign policy blueprint of the world's second largest economy. Yes, we're talking of the National Congress of the Chinese Communist Party, which has kicked off in Beijing today. Now, who attends the Party Congress? 2,300 Communist Party members will gather in the Great Hall of the People in Beijing. They include factory workers and farmers from the provinces. And these are live shots coming to you from the venue of the Party Congress beginning in Beijing. Just to bring our viewers up to speed, these are live visuals coming to you from the Great Hall of the People in Beijing, where the 19th Party Congress of the Communist Party of China has begun. All right, coming back to the report about who will gather in the Great Hall of the People in Beijing. Now, they include factory workers and farmers from the provinces, armed forces personnel, civil servants from distant parts of China, also women, although their numbers are smaller. Now, none of these members are elected, rather they've been carefully selected in a process involving Communist Party branches at the village, county and town levels. Each and every one of them have been selected based on their loyalty to the party, its ideals and its leadership. There are no surprise decisions here, only confirmation of what has been discussed in party circles all over the country. All right, coming to the next big question that is agitating and, being talked about in many parts of the world. What's China's 19th Party Congress all about? Now, the Party Congress is China's highest decision-making body. The Congress brings together party members every 5 years. The week-long Congress is held under the supervision of the General Secretary, in this case, President Xi Jinping, who is also the General Secretary of the party. Now, Xi Jinping is also president and head of the Central Military Commission. So what happens at the Party Congress and why is it so important to China and to the world? Now, what happens at the Party Congress? Xi Jinping will present the achievements of his government in the past 5 years. He will also report on the way ahead for the party and the government. The report reflects the consensus reached within the party on what has been achieved in the last 5 years. Therefore, it takes 1 year to prepare. Expect the report to praise the anti-corruption campaign, the structural economic reforms and great power relations. It'll sum up the move towards achieving the goal of a moderately well-off society by the year 2021. All right, so if the idea of holding this Congress is to confirm what has been discussed in the inner circles of the Communist Party of China, then why hold the Congress at all? It's important to understand that in China, the Communist Party is the only legal party permitted under the laws. But it still has to reach out to the people. It must mold public opinion, and this is done through the party branches all over the country. Party members have privileges denied to non-party members. The Party Congress thus brings together party faithfuls from all over China and gives them a glimpse of what they could aspire to, and also confirms the power and deep roots of the party. It cements alliances across provinces, builds relationship networks and provides the path to political power. All right, staying on the story, the Party Congress is also about China's new leadership. Not that President Xi Jinping is going to change. All Chinese presidents are entitled for 2 5-year terms. Xi has completed one term already and is lined for a second consecutive 5-year term. This was decided in 2002 to bring stability and predictability in the process of succession in China. But more on that later. Let's first look at what else the Party Congress will do apart from approving President Xi Jinping's report. The Congress will elect 370 members to the Central Committee. The Central Committee is a political body. It oversees the work of all party organs. It elects the General Secretary. Currently, it is President Xi Jinping. It will also elect by secret ballot 25 members of the Politburo. Now, the Politburo headed by Xi Jinping is like a council of ministers. It is assisted by a Politburo Standing Committee, which is Xi Jinping's inner cabinet. All right, we now come to the million-dollar question. What happens to Xi Jinping? Now, as mentioned earlier, all Chinese presidents are entitled to 2 5-year terms. So Xi will get his second 5-year term, no doubt. Reports say Xi is keen on staying for a longer period now. He is already China's most powerful leader in decades. Now, since he is General Secretary of the Party, President of China and Chairman of the Central Military Commission, reports say he is as powerful as Chairman Mao, the founder of the People's Republic of China. Now, last year, Xi Jinping was designated a core leader, but Xi Jinping's thoughts on scientific development are yet to be enshrined in the Communist Party's constitution. He needs some more loyalists in the Politburo Standing Committee. That is not guaranteed, however, as Xi has made powerful enemies on his way to the top. His anti-corruption campaign has upset vested interests. The military is angry for its part with the removal of no less than 40 generals. Now, more than 13,000 party officials have been sacked or jailed, again, on the issue of corruption charges. The conduct of some people close to Xi has added to the sentiment against him. So, although Xi Jinping is powerful and in all probability he will have his way, there is really no guarantees. All right, so what does the Chinese Party Congress mean for India? Now, if Xi Jinping emerges stronger from the Party Congress, it has many implications. For instance, Western analysts believe that Xi sees virtue in finding enemies any and everywhere. This partly explains his crackdown on corruption, which has helped him eliminate adversaries within the party. He is no use for Western freedoms and has waged a fierce campaign against any form of political dissent. Even the internet is policed and monitored to an unprecedented degree in China today. Now, when India refused to back down, Xi may have told his generals to back off, but China watchers here say he has neither forgiven India nor forgotten. Expect trouble further down the road. That's what the sentiment in India today is. Now, he will deepen ties with Pakistan, seeing advantage in cultivating that country strategically. He will make steady inroads into Nepal and Bangladesh too. Sri Lanka is virtually in his pocket since it owes China billions of dollars for loans it cannot repay. Now, the National Party Congress is an opportunity to gauge the profile of the top leadership in China. Some of these people are close to President Xi and can be expected to play key roles in running China. For instance, the people to watch are Li Jiangzhu, 67 years old, the president's trusted advisor already on the Politburo, and he could take over as head of the Disciplinary Commission. The second person to look out for is Han Zhang, 63 years old, Shanghai party chief, has overseen Shanghai's transformation. He's linked to former president Jiang Zemin. The third person to watch out for is Wang Yang, 62 years old, currently is vice premier of the state council and is already on the Politburo membership. Key negotiator in trade talks with the United States. Fourth person is Wang Huning, 62 years old, an academic and political theorist, foreign policy advisor to three presidents, including current president Xi Jinping. The advocates strong central leadership. Fifth person to watch out for is Zhao Leji, 60 years old, the chief of personnel in the Communist Party. He has overseen every top-level appointment in recent years and a close associate of President Xi. The sixth person to watch out for is Li Qishang, 58 years old, party secretary of Jiangsu province, a crucial regional political position, and is lined for central leadership role. And most importantly, he has age on his side. Seventh person is Chen Miners, 57 years old, party chief of Chongqing province. Good record as chief of Guizhou province. Protege of President Xi has age on his side. Next, we move to Hu Chunhua, 54 years old, party chief of Guangdong province. He revitalized the economy with focus on services and high technology areas and also has advantage of age. Now, like most Chinese leaders, he is inscrutable and bland in his dark suits. But Xi Jinping is reckoned as China's most powerful leader since possibly Chairman Mao. A look at the princeling turned president now.
He has the appearance of a benign uncle, but watch him closely as he greets visiting leaders in Beijing. They are always pictured as walking up to him. The greeting and the handshake, they're both businesslike. It would seem that Xi Jinping, president of China, is the 21st century avatar of China's Manchu emperors, or Qing, if you want to go back further. There's no doubt President Xi wants to be up there. He's already been anointed the core leader in the manner of the late Chairman Mao. And if his carefully crafted plans succeed, he will be anointed for an unprecedented third term at the National People's Congress beginning Wednesday. Here are some facts about Xi Jinping's background. Xi is a princeling. That means he is the son of a veteran communist who held key positions in the 1960s. Xi has used the princeling network to rise through the ranks of the Communist Party. His loyal ally, Wang Qisang, is carrying out a ruthless anti-corruption campaign. President Xi holds three key posts: General Secretary of the Communist Party, President and Head of the Military Commission. President Xi has a keen eye on the world stage. Mindful of America's steady decline, he is driving an ambitious agenda of China first with the multi-billion dollar One Belt, One Road initiative. It hasn't quite taken off and there have been stumbles and obstacles, but Xi will persevere. He's not hesitated to flex muscle in the South China Sea, but when threats and intimidation of India on the Doklam Plateau in Bhutan did not work, he was quick to diffuse tensions and deal. President Xi's rise to the top is unprecedented in China. Western analysts say he's made powerful enemies internally. He's sown the seeds of suspicion and doubt over China's intentions worldwide. The princeling-turned president's rise or fall could be a game-changer either way. Bureau Report, WION.